This is the end that has a chisel end on it and a dimple. And this dimple is simply taking. And if you leave this sort of, don't round that, it means that whichever way I jam it, it will not want to roll on me. It will try to stay upward like that. And the weight of the pot now would push down on that, except for the fact that I have two fork sticks. So, jam in further, or we even move these back. They could have been shorter. There. And this here, usually you try to get this slice here level, where the dimple goes. There. Now the next thing is they kind of put your knife away so you don't jam yourself when you break the stick. Here we go again. Leave about every 6 inches. At this stage, here's something that I find really gets in the way, and I still haven't done this, but there, now I'll be a lot happier. Boy, I hate those guards. You might, a lot of people like the guards, but they all flabbergasted it. Fact that I do that. You can buy these knives without guards. Okay, now we have the completion of these cuts. Tidy them up a bit. These here engage into that dimple I made earlier. Fairly stable. Usually you can rock it quite a bit, and it should be pointed so it doesn't walk off of it. See, up here that's at simmer. Lower it down near the fire. That's at a little hotter. Here it's right touching the fire so that it's at the lowest level. That's kind of trickery to be able to moderate the effect of the fire. You can, you know, if you got a constantly burning fire, you usually cook your stuff by raising the pot higher or lower. I saw this on Burtonsville Island, and I thought it was such an interesting rig that I named it the Burtonsville Rig. Wouldn't it embarrass me if it fell off? So actually bumping against it, you're not going to dislodge it. A lot of people worry that it's not very secure, but there's a nice dimple, and that pointy end is sitting right in the dimple.